had 7th and 8th rib fracture. I believe a hip fracture on the right, bilateral knee fractures. One of his femurs were fractured, and then bilateral ankle fractures. So basically from the hips down, fractured. He's survived the fall, but is he gonna survive, you know, like all the complications from surgery. And then just the rehab part of it. Can they put the tendons and ligaments and everything back in order so then he can walk? I mean, he's a pretty young guy, so he's gonna need his legs.
He was in a lot of pain, but he, surprisingly, for someone being in so much pain, he had such a positive attitude. A lot of times, you know, patients feel vulnerable, you know, trying to figure out what they can do to help, you know, and all patients want to help, but a lot of times we have to let them relax, you know, to turn him. And he had so many things going on with his back, you know, always hurting when you turned him, not just with his legs, but his back, his ribs, you know, he had fractured so many bones. And just, I had offered to give him a pill to kind of splint himself so he had a job, you know, at least felt like he was doing something and not, you know, had a little bit of control over his care also. He isn't a quitter, you know. You could tell people just by talking with them and about their injuries and how they do with therapy. And when you come back that night, you can, during report, we would get how they, you know, the patient does with therapy. You could tell he was a fighter. He always, you know, wanted to try to do things on his own. So you always know that he's gonna make it, you know, in the long run, he's not gonna give up.
It's a shame that we don't have something outside of words to express gratitude and feelings. The adjectives to describe my entire care team seem insufficient, because from the person cleaning my room to the person administering coming in, checking my vitals, administering whatever medicines that they wanted me to have, to the people who brought food, you know, breakfast, lunch, the nurses who would answer the call button, bring me a popsicle at 2:30 in the morning because it, you know, the rare instance I can have a popsicle at 2:30 in the morning. Somebody would willingly do that. To Nicole, who found that extra little bit of care, saw the distress that I was in, and had a suggestion. Can I get you a hug pillow? That's one of those mountaintop experiences. When she handed me that pillow, I thought I was falling into a cloud. Nicole exemplified the totality of the care I received. Everyone had that level of concern and heart, and it was on display all the time. I can't say enough about, again, what you call the care team. Those people charged with caring for me while I was here in the hospital. And I experienced it throughout and have continued to experience it. My accident is not going to define me, but hopefully my recovery will. If I never got any better than I am today, I'd be okay.